Hi, I'm Ross Mayfield, Investment Strategy Analyst at Baird, and we are back for another weekly video with our friends at Strategas. Today, I'm thrilled to be joined by Managing Director and Head of Fixed Income Research, Tom Tzitzouris, to talk all things fixed income and inflation. Tom, how are you doing this morning?
Good morning, Ross. Good. It's a pleasure to be here.
Yeah, glad to have you. A lot of activity since we talked last, a surprise inflation beat, a Fed rate hike that we haven't seen in 30-ish years of 75 basis points. So a lot of activity, yields kind of spiking and then pulling off a bit lately. I want to turn it over to you just to maybe get, what is the most surprising thing to you about all this activity, and where do you see everything going from here as far as rates and inflation?
Well, I think that this most surprising bit of data over the last month is really that inflation has not begun to roll over, even slowly. That is, it's actually accelerated higher again in the month of May. It's not totally surprising, but there's definitely some element of fear that has come back into financial markets, because there was an expectation, very broad expectation, that inflation would have peaked in March or April, even at an elevated or high level, and then slowly begun to come down. It appeared that was the case in April, and then May gave us another push higher, which really shocked markets. And no surprise, you got a really knee-jerk reaction from the Fed, not necessarily unwarranted, but rather quite warranted in the 75 basis point rate hike. And that in and of itself spooked the financial markets. Going forward, the expectation is probably once again that we've hit peak inflation and that we should see a very slow rollover and push lower. And financial markets should see gradually improving and reduced volatility over the remainder of this year. If that proves to be untrue, that is, we see a further push higher in inflation, then all bets are off and volatility is going to accelerate again.
Yeah, certainly a lot of headline volatility in the week after that surprise inflation report dropped on a Friday. I have a question around if Fed policy is working and what that looks like to you. You know, you look at something like mortgage rates and how those have spiked alongside the spike in the 10-year and other key rates. Is Fed policy working? And if so, you know, how much further do they need to go to actually accomplish the goal that they laid out in their most recent economic projections, which, you know, shows inflation higher than they expected, rates having to peak higher than they expected? Is it working?
Well, it's working, but Fed policy always works with the proverbial long and variable lags. This time would be no different. And so it appears to be working, but you would not really expect to see Fed policy make a significant impact on inflation until you're at least a quarter into tightening, or possibly as far as 12 months into tightening. So we should expect to see more and more impact from Fed policy in the second half of the year. With that said, there are areas or pockets of the economy that are already showing the impact from Fed policy, both rate hikes as well as balance sheet reduction, and the housing market is one of them. Balance sheet reduction has really, in the early going, and just the simple fear of balance sheet reduction has pushed 10-year Treasury rates up to 3.50 at one point in time about a week and a half ago, and that pushed mortgage rates up to about 6%, the highest we've seen in at least a decade. So that is already impacting the housing market, and it's already beginning to filter through to that portion of the U.S. economy. So it's beginning to work, albeit with drips and drabs.
Sure, that makes plenty of sense. So, you know, we've seen this big rally in yields, you know, really over the past 6 months, and a ton of fixed income market volatility along the way. With yields where they are today, are you all starting to find some value in duration? Are you more worried about credit quality at this point? Where are you all starting to find some value or leg into the fixed income markets, you know, in your portfolios?
Yeah, you know, I would phrase this in somewhat mathematical terms. Right now, with the rise in yields, we'll say 10-year Treasury about 3.15% as of this morning. With that rise in Treasury yields, it really, I wouldn't say it's created value. It's created a market where the risks are more symmetric than they have been in probably any time in the last 5 to 7 years. That in and of itself doesn't create value. It just means that you have a bit more of an even distribution. We would have to see 10-year yields rise probably another 30 basis points, if not 40 basis points, before we would start to describe that as a valuable asset where there's legitimately more upside risk than downside risk. So I don't think there's much value there. And the same can be said for investment grade corporates, high yield mortgage-backed securities, because even if we've seen peak 10-year yields, we probably have not seen peak spreads for this cycle by any means. And that means very likely you're likely to see corporate yields rise further, even if treasury yields stall out here. So I don't think value is a way to think about it. But for investors who are short or underweight versus a benchmark, this has been a great opportunity to cut those shorts and get closer to benchmark neutral.
Right. And credit quality, certainly something to watch as we go forward. As you mentioned, spreads haven't blown out nearly to the level that we've seen, you know, in past kind of equity market sell-offs, especially when you're looking for the bottom of that sell-off. So something to keep an eye on for sure. We'll talk to you again soon. I appreciate the time. This has been really valuable. And again, hopefully catch up again later this summer. But thanks for the time.
Yeah, my pleasure.